Magandang umaga, TV fam. Another day, another vlog. So, right now, papunta tayo sa airport. Susunduin lang natin yung mga pinsan ko at saka yung tita ko. They're coming from Toronto, Ontario. They're going here to visit BC para lang at least, you know, ma-explore nila kung ano ba ang meron dito, and then ililibot namin sila sa mga key places dito sa Richmond, and then after that mag-explore din sila sa downtown at saka sa Victoria, BC. So hopefully, you know, as part na tong vlog na to, hopefully pumayag yung pinsan ko, kasi maganda din yung nakuha niyang field of work na gusto kong ma-share sa inyo para ma-consider nyo. Sana pumayag siya, no, at ma-interview natin siya para malaman natin ano ba yung mga education na kailangan para makakuha ng trabaho na kapareho ng trabaho na nakuha niya or field niya. So, ang kagandahan dito is healthcare related kasi siya, yung field of work niya. Gusto natin sana malaman gaano katagal niya natapos tong education niya para dito, ano yung mga process na in-undertake niya, and from the time halimbawa na nag-graduate siya, mabilis bang nakakuha ng trabaho? If not, how long bago ka makakuha ng first job mo after graduating that particular field? Kasi ang kagandahan dito, pinag-aagawan siya ng companies eh. So kahit na hindi siya hindi siya naghahanap, you know, marami nag-message sa kanya na, oh, baka gusto mo lumipat dito, yung ino-offer na siya ng mga, binibigyan siya ng mga job offers on different areas. Na tingin ko, magandang opportunity to na ma-share ko sa inyo kung ano ba yung mga in-demand, you know, opportunities na pwede nyo makonsider pag lumipat kayo dito sa Canada. So yun lang, mamaya na lang ulit, and then susunduin ko na sila sa airport. So we have our visitor. Hi, Nico. Hi, Tita Cora. Hi, Joyanne. Simple, simple, simple minds. I guess we'll take it one by one, baby, one by one. Just different, different, different kinds. We'll try to take it one by one, baby, one by one. So many problems. I'm already lost, yeah. My baby, I do. I miss you too. Morning, TV fam. Another day, another vlog. So, nung huling beses niya, sinabi ko sa inyo na dumating yung iba sa mga cousins ko dito sa BC. And nilibot natin sila, no, dito sa area para at least malaman nila kung ano ba yung difference ng pamumuhay dito sa BC versus sa Ontario. So for today's vlog niya, nakita nyo naman doon sa title, interviewin natin yung isa sa pinsan ko dahil nasa medical field siya. Actually, majority naman sa kanila nasa medical field. But medyo interesting lang kasi yung field na napili niya na I think magiging beneficial sa inyo. Interesting lang kasi yung napili niya field dahil hindi siya, I guess, regular na first choice in a sense. Kasi di ba pag sinabi mong medical field, usually yan, nurses, yan. Yan ang usual field sa medical. Pag sinabi mong Filipino, nurse, di ba, laging ganyan. Ang topic natin today is gusto kong ma-share sa inyo yung field na napili niya, na i-pursue dito sa Canada, na hopefully makatulong sa inyo sa pagde-decide sa potential career path dito sa Canada. Okay, TV fam, so kasama natin ngayon ang ating special guest. So we have here Nico, yung cousin ko. Hi, Nico.
Hi.
Okay, nandito tayo ngayon sa Deer Lake. And so tatanungin na natin siya para na siguro magkaroon kayo ng information about kung ano yung na-choose niya na field dito sa Canada. Ano yung course mo dito sa Canada?
So, profession ko, radiation therapist. So, it's under the Bachelor of Medical Radiation Sciences.
I believe tatlo yung programa na under dito sa career path na to. Ano yung tatlo na yun dito?
So, meron siyang radiation technologist. So, ayun yung mga X-ray, MRI tech, CT tech, ultrasound or sonographers, and yung profession ko, which is radiation therapist. So pretty much treating cancer patients using high radiation.
Yeah. Doon sa tatlo na yun, bakit mo napili yung radiation therapy?
Kasi siya yung pinakamataas yung sub.
Practical. Practical na practical na sagot.
So, siya rin yung pinakamahirap out of the three kasi konti lang yung applicants na pinipili nila. Because it's very specific.
I see.
And you can only work in cancer centers.
Ah.
So, that's why yung, well, my class only had about
15
students. Yeah.
Yung na-accept.
Yun na aksap.
Doon sa tatlo, knowing na yun na nga yung pinakamataas yung sweldo,
mm-hmm.
meron pa bang ibang reason kung bakit yung napili or yun na talaga yung pinaka-goal?
Nagtanong din ako sa yung kaibigan, naging kaibigan ko rin na nagtitake ng medical radiation. Nag-shadow din ako dun sa cancer center.
Okay.
And the good thing about it is like, you get to do a lot of things. So, meron nag-deliver ng treatment, so you get to see the patients.
Okay.
Sometimes they have 30 treatments
okay.
every day for radiation, so you get to know them.
Mm-hmm.
Compared sa, for example, X-ray o ultrasound, kapag may test lang sila, one
na
time
ginagawa.
Lang sila
Oh, I see. Parang meron siyang follow-up process
exactly.
apart dun sa paggawalan ng
yeah,
test.
Yeah, so you get to know the patients for quite some time.
Okay.
And then, hindi lang naman yung pag-deliver ng radiation, we also like simulate and then plan the radiation treatment. So, maraming areas, hindi lang nag-administer ka.
Parang, in short, parang mas exciting.
Yes, exactly.
So, in terms of dun sa tatlong kategory na yun, sanabi na nga natin na mas mataas yung sweldo ng radiation therapy, in terms of number of years para matapos mo siya, pare-pareho lang ba?
Yes, pare-parehas lang.
Which is, ano, 4 years?
So,
or?
It depends on school because, like, I went to McMaster University in Mohawk.
Okay.
So, you can go straight from high school. Pero sa some universities, you need 1 year of undergrad.
Okay.
And then, it will be a 3-year program. Yeah, but technically, they kind of, like, squeeze it into from a 5-year or 4-year program. Kasi you don't get summer vacation.
Vacations?
Yeah, for the...
First 2 years?
The second and third year.
Ah, second and third year. Chinek ko kanin kasi yung websites. Meron din pala siyang certificate program.
Oh.
So, anong difference ng certificate program versus sa 4-year bachelor's degree apart from the number of years?
Yeah, so I think sa radiation therapy, I'm not sure if may certificate program specifically for radiation therapy kasi I don't think that's allowed sa radiation therapy but sa X-ray radiation tech.
Yeah.
So if you take the certificate program, their title will be radiation technicians.
Okay.
Pero pag the 4-year bachelor's, it's actually radiation technologists.
I see.
So, may limited scope of practice lang if you're a radiation technician compared sa radiation technologist.
Okay.
Yeah, so obviously the pay
is different.
Yeah, and then yung responsibilities mo are different.
Yeah. So, pinag-usapan natin pay. So, without disclosing yung actual pay mo, umpisahan natin from the time na nag-graduate ka, no, ng 4-year course mo, nakakuha ka ba kagad ng trabaho?
Yes, so you need to write the national board exam
okay.
and get your license
okay.
before you can practice. But after that, luckily I was able to get a job dun sa clinical placement ko.
Because
the last year of your school, it will be like purely clinical.
Clinical.
So like a practical work.
Okay.
So if you do well in that one, most likely they'll hire you.
Are you? Okay. Yeah. So starting from that point, in terms of pasahod, salary, what was their initial offer after mo mag-graduate?
Oh, that's a long time ago.
Yeah, so yeah.
More than 10 years
year
ago.
Oh, okay, more than 10 years ago.
I would say 2012.
2012, okay.
Yeah, 2012.
Okay.
The offer was like, I think similar to nurses. Yeah,
which
about
is
like $32 the study.
An hour.
Yeah,
pero ngayon, 32. May idea ka ba sa mga newly graduate ng ganung course?
Yes.
Magkano yung ino-offer na nila?
Yeah, actually, most of them are UNS and you can find them online.
Yeah, okay.
So they're all posted. BC offers the most, and
okay,
then Alberta.
Uh-huh.
And I think the new grads now start at 6 figures.
No! God, please, no! No!
Ooh, six figures kagad.
Yeah.
So okay, 6 figures pero ano to ah, regular hours lang to, wala tong OT.
Yes, yeah. That's
so pag sinabi mong regular hours, is it 8 to 5? Anong ibig sabihin ng regular hours?
So good thing about the radiation therapy, it's kind of like office work.
Office work.
So like you don't get weekends, walang shift work. So it's about 8 to 4, 9 to 5. Sometimes the latest will be 10 to 6.
Okay.
But since the demand keeps increasing, I think some of the centers open until 7 now.
Oh, that's
good. So you have
good
11 to 7 shifts. So but yeah, that's pretty much the latest.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. We're talking about 6 figures dito. In terms of career growth, meron ba siyang mga next levels? Ano ba yung tinitingnan natin na growth sa career path na to?
So every year, since yung unionized ka, the experience counts, so you get paid, your salary increases every year.
Yeah.
So, but it masses up to like your 7 year.
7 year.
So they give you the maximum,
uh-huh,
and then after that, it will be just like yung adjustment of cost of living.
Which is ilang percent normally yun?
So
2.5, 3?
Yeah, 2 to 3%.
Okay.
Every year.
Uh-huh.
But some people will go to management or actually like sales then.
Yeah, yeah.
And like, yeah.
That is if kung interested kang mag-manage ng tao, tama ba?
Yes, that's correct. Yeah.
Okay, napag-usapan natin yung salary, career path. Siguro isa sa mga question natin dito is, marirekomenda mo ba na kunin tong gantong klaseng career para sa mga, you know, students?
Yes, yeah, especially right now. When I started, the job market wasn't that good.
Mm.
So it kind of goes into cycle. But right now, since the population really increased the past few years, so more cancer centers are opening up. So the demand is actually very high for radiation therapists.
Oh,
and
okay.
I believe there are only 6 schools in Canada that offer that program.
Oh, wow.
And since a lot of people hindi naman siya kilala.
Yeah.
So I don't know if they actually fill all the spots.
Gotcha. Okay.
Yeah. So kasi napaka-niche din naman ng ano ng profession.
Ng profession.
Yeah, so it's pretty uncommon compared to, for example, nursing,
yeah,
right? Or lab tech.
Mm-hmm. So napag-usapan natin na nabanggit mo yung nursing. Kasi majority, pag sinabi natin Pilipino, lagi yan, pag healthcare, nurse kagad ang pinag-uusapan. Bakit radiation therapy yung napili mo instead of pursuing nursing?
Kasi ayoko ng shift work din. Like 12 hours
oh, yeah,
of shift
yeah
work. And it's more of a technical
yeah
job
uh-huh
in terms of like very highly detail oriented.
Yeah.
So you still deal with patients, but not as much compared to nursing.
Nursing.
Yeah. Mas marami siyang bedside.
Oh.
Yeah, and then yung patients na dinideal namin naman, ano siya, outpatients naman.
Outpatient.
Siya. So they're pretty much in a good condition. So.
Oh, that's true.
Nursing, yeah.
Oh, that's a good point. Tama naman yun. So tinanong natin kung marirekomenda mo yung gantong path between the 4-year course at saka yung 2-year course.
Mm-hmm.
If let's say international student,
yeah,
kukunin niya 2-year course, marirecommend na mo pa rin ba? Do you think may path pa rin ng growth that will support, you know, needs ng family if certificate course lang kukunin mo, or kailangan dapat bachelor's?
I think if you can, I would strive some
bachelor's.
Kasi it really opens up way more opportunities,
yeah,
compared sa certificate
program. Yeah, yeah, okay.
Because like not a lot of like, for example, radiation therapy, I don't know any center that will accept on a certificate program.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Pero pag maybe sa X-ray or radiation technologist, meron siguro sila.
Yeah.
So, but it really limits the amount of opportunity.
Yeah. Pero siguro ang question din natin dyan is, madali, sabi mo kanina, medyo selected lang yung nakakapasok sa ganitong profession eh.
Mm.
Madali bang mag-adjust or mag-shift ng career, or kailangan nasa top 10 ka ng class before kang mag, I guess, mag-progress sa ganitong klaseng career?
I wouldn't say so na kailangan mo talaga na nasa top pa.
Okay.
As long na you're familiar about like basic like anatomy,
yeah,
like biology, those things.
Okay.
So pretty much like a nurse can apply for this job.
Yeah.
Or like person who wants to specialize nursing well. Maybe instead of nursing, if they want to do something else, they can apply.
Sa
radiation therapist.
Doon sa field mo, meron ba tong specialization apart doon sa regular machines na ginagamit sa field?
Sa Canada, for specifically for radiation therapists, we can do what we call like CT simulators, which the ones like plan that determine the position for the treatment, or like yung planning,
yeah,
or what we call a dosimetrist. But I know different countries need special certifications. For example, sa US,
yeah,
radiation therapists cannot be a dosimetrist, so kailangan nila maging mag-aral ulit for a dosimetry school.
Oh, okay.
So it depends kung saan sila and like yung regulations ng specific country na yun.
Oh, I see.
But
oh,
in Canada, radiation therapists can do different areas.
Pinag-uusapin natin sa career na to is radiation. That's the key term. Pero may ano ba siya? Health hazard ba siya considered?
No, actually it's very, very safe in terms of if you're worried about the exposure. We have equipments that we all usually wear, what we call a dosimeter, to measure the amount of radiation, and they measure it every quarterly. And in fact, flight attendants and pilots actually get way more radiation than us.
Wow! Yeah. Yeah, good point. No? Kasi sabi nga ni Nico, is mas marami pa raw nakukuhang radiation ang mga piloto at saka mga flight attendants, mm-hmm, right? In terms of job security, kasi diba dito sa Canada, madami nang nalilay off. Sa mga group of peers mo, meron ka bang nakita or na-experience na merong na-layoff sa profession na ginagawa mo?
Never. Okay. So, I've been working for more than 10 years. I've never seen someone with a layoff.
Laid off?
Yeah. I think, ayun din yung security. If you're in healthcare,
yeah,
yeah, you're pretty much in need. So, especially right now, the demand is really great.
Yeah.
Yeah, so maybe, once you're in, it's pretty much like guaranteed.
That's it. Guaranteed.
That, like, you'll work there until you retire or you leave.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. So, doon sa mga group of friends mo, peers mo, or even nakikilala mo sa hospital, meron bang umaalis sa field? At kung meron, saan sila nag-shift?
Yeah. So, I think especially sa, during COVID, yeah, a lot of people found different opportunities in terms of like my profession's sales.
Sales?
Yeah, or
when you say sales, anong binibenta nila?
So, for example, like yung company na nag-develop ng machines. Yeah,
ah,
or like the softwares that we use.
Okay.
So, they're the ones who do the training and then selling those products to different cancer centers, new upcoming hospitals. Most of them, it's because of the remote work as well, right? They'll be able to work.
Okay,
from
remotely,
home,
yeah,
instead of like being on site to treat
patients. Pero ikaw existing lang ngayon, you're working remote.
Yes. So I'm working as a dosimetrist most of the time. So I work half and half. Since I'm planning the radiation treatment, I just use the computer.
Yeah.
Yeah, access the hospital servers to plan the actual radiation treatment. So I don't need to see the patient.
Oh, okay.
Since I don't administer the treatment.
Okay.
So I just plan their treatment remotely.
Tinanong natin, or kanina sinabi mo, yung iba nag-shift sa sales. Pag nag-shift ba sa sales, mas madaming pera?
I think initially, it's kind of like a salary cut, pero mas yung opportunity to earn more is
Bigger.
Way bigger.
Kasi pag halimbawa may nabenta kang machine.
Yeah, no? Mission and bonuses. Yeah. Yeah. Since yung ngayon, it's a government job, yeah. You usually don't get bonuses, di ba?
Oh, yeah.
So
yeah.
It's just like a base rate. Yeah.
Kung halimbawa, ganyan na yung profession nyo sa Philippines, i-accredit ba siya dito sa Canada?
Yeah, that's a really good question. Kasi you just need to pass the national board exam,
okay,
in order to get the license, and you can practice as a radiation therapist or sonographer or X-ray tech.
Uh-huh.
Dito sa Canada, as long na
mapass mo.
Yeah, so you don't have to go back to school.
So wala kang additional credentials na kailangan makuha or ma-attain. Walang additional training na kailangan. Well, training kasama naman yung pag natanggap ka. Pero other than that, kasi yung iba nagpapare-license, meron kang kailangan number of credits na kailangan ma-attain bago ka mag-exam. Yeah. So you're saying na dito, wala.
Not 100% sure, okay. Pero all the information that they need nasa
website.
Sa website. It outlines there yung kailangan ng guidelines or requirements for international applicants.
Okay,
and how they can practice here in Canada.
Okay. Knowing na meron kang experience na nag-exam ka, pumasa ka, masasabi mo bang mahirap, madali, medium, or tingin mo kayang-kaya naman kung talagang pag-aaralan at pagtatsagaan?
Mahirap siya. Exam was hard. Pero as long na you study the materials, they also outline what kind of questions that they will ask exam.
Okay.
Dun sa website na yon.
Is it multiple choice ang tanong, or is it like question and answer? Parang essay type?
Multiple choice. Yeah.
Oh, multiple choice.
They keep changing yung type ng exam.
Uh-huh.
Pero I think multiple choice na ngayon.
Oh, okay. Is this online, electronic, or you need to be present pag ginawa mo yung exam?
So, may different exam centers sila dito sa different provinces.
Yeah. Yung exam mo per se, ano to? One day lang ba or multiple dates na kailangan mong attendan?
It's only a one-day exam. But
one day.
Before, it was multiple days.
Multiple days.
Then they changed it. I'm pretty sure right now it's just a one-day exam.
One day.
Yeah.
Yung one day na yon, ilang hours
yeah.
yung kinilangan para matapos yung exam?
When I did it was 6 hours.
6 hours.
Pero
no
ngayon,
break.
Yeah. Oh, I think they give you a break.
Okay.
Adult, pero ngayon, I'm not sure kung 4 hours or 5 hours siya ngayon.
Ah.
Yeah, I'm not too familiar yung process.
Yeah, yung process. Okay. Again, kung interested kayo, puntahan nyo lang yung website. Again, lalagay ko dyan sa screen para malaman nyo yung mga requirements, ano ba yung kailangan. And siguro, nabanggit niya sa akin ni Nico, if may experience ka na sa ganitong klaseng field, masasabi mo bang pabor yun sa mga may experience na kaysa sa wala?
Yeah, especially ngayon na shortage kami. Meron kami mga recently nag-hire sila sa center namin. Na,
yeah.
The guy from India.
India.
Nagpa-practice na siya.
Okay.
And then he passed the board exam.
Okay.
And yeah, they sponsored him actually.
Sponsored?
To work here.
Hindi naman pala mababaliwala yung naging experience mo sa ibang country sa field na to. Unlike yung mga non-medical related career path, kapareho ko, no? So, advantage pa rin yun. So, again, kung interested kayo, yung website, nandyan sa screen nyo, tignan nyo lang yan, observe nyo. And then, kung meron kayong mga katanungan, i-comment nyo lang dyan below sa video link natin, no? And then, hopefully, tatanungin natin si Nico. No, ang expert natin sa field. Kung hopefully makatulong, no, masagot kahit pa paano yung katanungan regarding sa field na to. Sa mga naririnig mo, sa mga peers mo, ano yung narinig mo na parang highest salary na na-attain ng gantong field?
So, specifically this field?
Yeah, that field, yeah.
I would say 180.
180, that's yeah, close to a doctor rate. That's not
that's
bad.
Cool.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, totally. Kung ganun yung kinikita mo, actually, kahit na yung siguro yung wife mo or yung partner mo, hindi mo na kailangan pagtrabuhin if you're earning that much. Maganda yung career path, no? Something na pwede nyong ma-consider as you plan your career choice dito sa Canada. Being a professional in that field, ano yung advice na maibibigay mo sa mga interested na kunin tong gantong career path?
Just make sure na passionate din sila to about the profession, especially like taking care of like cancer patients.
Yeah.
So empathy,
yeah,
and at the same time, ano rin, talagang very technical.
Yeah.
Yeah, because like some of our tolerances of treatment is like we go by millimeters.
Yeah.
So very, very accurate in treatment because you can kill someone if you
That's true.
If you don't deliver the treatment correctly. So lots of responsibilities.
Yeah.
Yeah, but overall, it's a very rewarding job naman talaga.
Yeah.
Kasi you make a difference.
That's
right?
True. Mm-hmm. As a matter of fact, ang nakikita kong kagandahan dito is hindi mo nasasacrifice yung health mo.
Mm-hmm.
Dahil nga, hindi ka nag-work ng long hour shift, yeah. Like 12 hours. Yung iba straight, 4 days, 12 hours, tama ba?
Yeah. So
right? Yung si Nico, ang schedule niya is 5 days mm-hmm. a week.
Monday to Friday.
Monday to Friday. Yeah. No weekends. You can enjoy on a weekend, which is very good, lalo na kung pamilyado kang tao.
Mm-hmm.
Yung mga nurse na ngayon, how long or ano yung mga, may idea ka ba kung ano yung kailangan nilang gawin para makuha or ma-attain nila yung ganyang license as a radiation therapist?
I'm pretty sure they have to go back to school.
But
they might accept some of the courses na na-take na nila.
Correct.
Pero kailangan talaga nila mag-aral ulit
to
get accepted to that program. Yeah, kasi specialized talaga siya.
Yeah. Just to let everyone know, si Nico, pinag-aagawan to ng mga kumpanya dito sa Canada. No, dahil nga very in high demand yung kanyang profession and kaunti lang talaga sila na mayroong gantong profession sa Canada. So, if interested kayo, try to look for this type of work. Maglalagay ako ng description sa baba. Parang sa ganun, kung interested kayo, try nyong basahin yon, tignan nyo para magkaroon kayo ng idea kung fit ba tong gantong klaseng profession para sa inyo.
Disclaimer. Everything is quoted sa Canadian Association of Medical Radiation Technologists in terms of the salary.
Yeah.
So different provinces, provinces have different rates.
Yeah.
Okay. So you can just check which one, but I know BC and Alberta offer the highest.
So check lang yung website na yan kung gusto niyo makita yung mga sweldo per province.
Uh-huh.
Magkaroon kayo ng more idea kung tama ba tong career path na to para sa inyo. Uh-huh. Tawag ito, siguro nagtataka kayo, magkano ba siguro yung tuition fee na kakailanganin ng isang student sa ganitong klaseng field? Si Nico, naglanda siya dito. What year naging landed PR?
2003, so okay. When I was still in early teens, yeah.
And what's that age? 11, 12? What?
I think 14.
14?
14 years old, yeah.
Okay, so dito na siya lumaki, dito siya nag-graduate.
Mm-hmm.
And then, iba kasi yung rate pag dito ka na, PR ka na dito,
mm-hmm.
right? Ang range ng tuition for a PR or citizen would be, magkano siya yearly?
Not too sure about now, pero I think mga 7,000 per year yata ngayon.
Yeah, I checked actually yung website, tama yung sinabi ni Nico. It ranges from 7 to 12,000 a year. No, so multiply niyo yun by 4 years, yun yung total na ginastos niya. Now, pag international student ka, iba yung rate. Ang rate na nakita ko per year ranges from 22,000 to 28,000. Depende sa province at saka depende sa type of program na kukunin mo. So medyo malaki-laking investment talaga siya. Now, question doon. Kaya bang pagsabahin ng trabaho at saka school?
I think kaya naman.
Kaya.
Pero I think dun sa siguro pag last year mo na kasi full-time clinical placement.
Okay.
So you'll be working Monday to Friday. like 8 hours.
Ah.
So you'll be there for like 8 months talaga na.
8 months straight.
As a, ano, as a full-time worker.
So kailangan mong i-quit yung existing work mo para matapos mo yung final year.
Yeah.
So make sure i-account nyo yun doon sa plan nyo at saka sa budget na kakailangan ninyo. Nung nag-migrate kayo dito, nahirapan ka bang mag-adjust sa school, sa environment, o wala, ang naka-adapt ka kagad?
Hindi naman masyadong nahirapan. I think naka-adapt naman talaga kasi wala naman masyadong language barrier.
Okay.
Nung nag-start ako dito, nung lumipat ako ng, nung high school, grade 10, I think.
Yeah.
Yeah, wala. Wala naman masyadong.
Sa school ba, kasi sa experience namin nung dumating kami dito, si Calvin and Chelsea pinasok sa English program para ma-enhance daw yung kanilang language or English proficiency. Wala ka bang ganun na experience sa Ontario?
Nung first year ko, yeah, nilagay kami sa ESL, so
yeah, yes.
English as Secondary Language,
yes.
Class. Mm-hmm. But after that, nasa regular na kami.
Nasa
so
regular
one year na. Lang na
pinasok.
Yeah, exactly.
Other than that, wala ka naman nakitang any major challenges na na-encounter mo nung nag-migrate kayo dito?
Wala naman. Actually, the courses were easier kasi mas yeah. advanced yung mga math, especially math, yeah. yung mga ganong courses
sa Pilipinas.
Sa Pilipinas,
yeah.
compared dito.
Alam mo, very true yun kasi dito nakafocus sila sa mag-enjoy yung mga bata during their elementary. Hindi sila more on academic. Kung nagtataka kayo, nasa Deer Lake pa rin kami. No, naglalakad kami. Nasa may highway kami, paikot na kami going back. Kung halimbawa, nasa later ka na ng age mo, between 40 to 60, existing nurse ka, do you think it's too late to shift sa ganyang klaseng profession?
No, I don't think so if you're committed.
Doon sa mga colleagues mo, meron ka bang nakita or na-meet na later in their age na nag-decide mag-switch from either nursing going to this profession?
Yes, one of my co-workers that just retired 5 years ago.
Actually, 5 years ago?
Was a doctor in Poland.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
And then she switched, took the radiation therapy program instead of like rewriting the board exam for.
Correct, for doctor.
Ah. Yeah. And and then worked until she retired for, I think, another 15 to 20 years.
15 to 20. So nasa 40s ba siya nung nag-switch siya?
Late 40s. She retired almost at the age of 70.
Okay. Yeah. So, ibig sabihin, kung kaya niya mag-retire at the age of 70 sa profession na to, doable, pwede mo rin gawin. Pwede kung hindi mo kailangan kagad mag-retire. Okay, so, Nico, maraming salamat.
Yeah, no problem.
No, really appreciate na nagpapaunlak sa katanungan. Naging interested talaga ako sa career niya dahil Monday to Friday, tapos medical field. Maganda yung benefits, maganda yung pay, and I don't think madami yung may alam na malaki yung magiging kinabukasan nila pag gantong klaseng career yung kinuha nila.
Mm-hmm. Right? Yeah, for sure. Hindi, unfortunately, hindi siya masyadong kilala kasi.
So, again, maraming salamat sa panunood. No? Kung nakaabot kayo sa parte ng video na to, click nyo na yung subscribe button kung hindi pa kayo subscriber ng ating channel. Mm-hmm. Share nyo na rin. Like nyo na rin kung meron kayong natutunan. So, hanggang sa muli, magkita-kita tayo ulit sa susunod na vlog.
Yeah.
Bye! Paalam! City of mine, how I love the city of mine. It never gets me down.